Good morning, everyone. It is a glorious day today because it is grim outside, but I'm feeling glorious from the inside, and that is what counts, people. I am trying to pull off a jumper duo today. I mean, obviously I'm not wearing shoes, so you can't tell properly, but this is a little cable knit situation, a little duo. I mean, if I had a longer torso, I'd probably have a bit of skin showing through, but I don't. And I actually straightened my hair today for the first time in ages, because I just felt like I couldn't be bothered to curl it, really. And I am wearing one of my favorite pieces from my collection, because this one actually is a double whammy. It's not just one earring, it's two. It's an earring and a stud, so have these little moon hoops, and they also come with these studs for your second piercings, or if you don't have a second piercing, you just get a free stud, basically. So I'll link these down below because they're so dainty and elegant. And the actual hoop has little crystals on it. I have a couple of parcels that I want to unbox today. However, we're gonna go next door because it is a very busy morning and I need my podcast equipment from the Room of Doom.
The morning is officially beginning because Belly and I are here.
It's a big spot. Oh god, good lord, I need to sit up. Hello posture. The sweater is doing not many favours for my face, many favours for my breasts. Don't include that. We've got a big day of podcast recording today.
Big day, because you might know that I missed a podcast week because I lost my voice. On Thursday, I uploaded a vlog that I filmed on Tuesday and Wednesday. Like, I like stuff to be real time, But on podcasts, you know, if you get sick, that's it. So we're getting ahead on the podcast now so that I don't miss.
Yeah, we don't want to leave anyone out in the lurch. I know. Even I, who is definitely not any sort of Insta celeb, got loads of messages from people saying, What are we going to do with our Monday? Where is my Monday gone?
I know, I felt so bad. We can't have
that happening again.
I need to reply to this email and we are waiting. Oh my god, you guys are going to die. It was being due today. Oh, did I get any good questions on my Instagram? I put it on my stories this morning saying, what do you want to know? Let's have a wee look. All right, prenups. This is the first comment.
I don't know, but both my parents were divorced before they met each other and then had me. Everyone else in my family, virtually everyone in my family is divorced. But I think that people seem to come from like either families where there's tons of it and everyone knows lots about it, or they don't really know very much. And I think that people see such contrasting experiences. Some people feel this like incredible new sense of life and they see that their parent or their uncle or their aunt or whoever is much happier. But then some people see a really negative side of things. And I think that now it's, I don't know what the statistics are, but it is so commonplace because there is no reason why people should be stuck in an unhappy situation if they are unhappy.
Yeah.
But getting advice and finding out what it actually all means, it can be really expensive to even sort of to speak to a lawyer. So I think it's important that we're educating people in some capacity, whether it's for them or for a friend or for whoever it might be, because you probably will come across divorce at some point in your life.
You know what someone told me? Now, I don't know if this is true, so don't quote me on this, because this is literally a quote of someone else's quote. What percentage of people leave without having another person? Like, without, you know.
I'm
not saying having an affair, I'm saying, like, you know, have another person ready to rumble.
What percentage of people leave with no one, on the back burner? Oh my god, is it going to be something really small at only 25%?
4%.
Stop!
That's... I need to Google this.
Do you know what I said to Amelia the other day? I said, I think we should do an episode on the psychology of adultery, because I think that adultery is so symptomatic of our generation. I think that whether it's through celebrities or whether it's through sort of like the negative side of social media, I think that adultery has become this like thing that seems to be on trend, when I personally think it's abhorrent and a really cowardly decision. But I think that we should definitely do some investigation about it, because it seems that no matter how beautiful someone might be, how amazing of a person, no one really escapes it.
Yeah,
I know people who are the more important than the fact that they're beautiful. They're beautiful people with doing amazing things in their life who just got caught completely off guard and found out that their other person was cheating. And it's terrible because I believe that it's not the person who cheats who suffers. I think it's the self-esteem of the person who gets cheated on. I think the person who cheats...
Self-esteem is so huge around that.
Yeah.
Okay, I have a question. Basically, back in the day, in my grandma's generation, let's say, when divorce was, like, frowned upon, it was less of an option, do you think people did still cheat, but they just turned a blind eye?
Definitely.
People just have way more options.
No, I think that, first of all, our grandparents' generation, divorce was not a situation that was happening, because they're also... people's perspective of what women did with their lives was really different. Everything, social values were so different. But I think that cheating was definitely commonplace. Everyone did it, but I think it was a lot more subtle than it is now.
Like social media and stuff, like phones. Like back in the day, if you were having an affair, you could just read someone's phone.
To go on a business trip, you'd go to the local and no one bar would know, and you'd pick someone up or whatever that might be, and that would be that.
This is great. Yeah, we should chat to first thing in the morning. Right, let's get the door.
Sweet beer. Well,
here. Oh, that's so funny. Final episode pre-Christmas.
Yeah, before Crimbo.
That was a great podcast.
Now, I'm not saying I would like to get divorced ever, but if I were, I definitely want Lucy to be my lawyer.
Same. She was great.
Yeah,
I really like her.
Recommend her.
She's very strong. This episode's coming out in a week. And it will be our last episode before Christmas. Oh, I need to say that on the podcast, don't I? Right. Belly is trying her first dunks. Are you ready?
Okay, so
are you ready for love? Yeah.
I'm interested in the consistency. Okay. I can feel that it's not pure crunch. There's a little bit of more.
I'm dying, so but you take this straight dunk. Yeah, okay, sorry. Go on, yeah. Yeah, you dunk. Into this one is caramel almonds, one of my faves.
Okay, I think it's quite important to let the audience know.
Yeah.
Are these like vegan? Okay, so I am the antichrist of all things vegan.
Oh no.
If I like them, it's a really big deal because I'm usually the first to slag this kind of stuff off. I've actually never eaten anything vegan before in my life. So Olivia,
I'm sure you have without knowing.
No, I have not.
Belly, you had my chocolate yesterday. That's vegan chocolate.
I didn't like it. Okay, well, Olivia, this is for you and all your hard work.
Okay. Better like it. What do you think? You have to tell us honestly now. And you didn't get enough sauce. You need
can
to
I
really...
double dip?
Yeah, you can double dip, I don't care.
I'm not ready to give my opinion yet.
Okay. A suspense. Bloody kill.
Like a fine wine. We'll indulge. Okay. Yeah, if you would take this exercise seriously, please.
We're waiting, yeah.
You're listening to me.
Mm-hmm.
I can tell that you've worked very hard on your product.
Oh, God.
No.
I'm being let down.
I wouldn't say I definitely get, like, caramel, but I do like the nuttiness of the whole experience, and the two textures were really enjoyable together. And I'm definitely not becoming vegan, but I would definitely eat this again.
Wow. I wasn't expecting that.
What other flavours are there?
Chocolate hazelnut.
Is that an intertent?
That's a great one. It's kind of like, you know, Dairy Lee Dunkers, but healthier. Okay. And I don't know if you would like the peanut. I don't love
peanut. No, I would. I don't even like peanut, but so far this is a positive start in my Olivia's relationship.
Wow, I'm thrilled for you.
Sponsor me.
Sponsor me first. I love her the most.
They are really nice because I think they're not pretending to be something else. Like, you can't give me a brownie made out of
sweet
dates and quinoa, and I'm going to tell you it's nice because it's just fucking not. Sorry, it's just not. It's just not. Anyone's lying. Betty Crocker, my main gal. Shout out to you.
Queen.
I went to meet a gut health skincare brand. It's really interesting. All about.
What was it called?
AIM.
Oh, I saw that on your Instagram. Mm.
I would just take this opportunity to plug myself. If you're interested in any other beauty related content, you can follow me on @BellRebecca_. Amelia's back now, so pretend I didn't say that.
Lit-a-thon. We've literally been sat here for 3 hours. I have not got up for 3 hours. We need to get up, Belly.
Good. We need to do a move around. Should we do a post-podcast dance?
Let's do a post-podcast dance. Shake it out. To the wall. Sweat down my balls.
I'll let you sing that live.
I actually need to...
Turn.
Okie dokie. We have a little house update over here, peoples, because I have some light facets, is that what they're called, in the bathroom, in my guest bathroom, that have no lights in them. So my guest bathroom is not a lit-a-thon. Oh, they're way bigger than I thought, I think.
Oh, wow.
The light goes in there.
How'd you get the bulb in?
I will show you, sweet dear. Hold on. This is my favourite place to order lamps. I don't have any... Oh no. No, I ain't up for this. This fucking screws and nails thing.
You could hardly do your desk chair.
I know, I was so proud of that. So my measuring isn't the best.
Turns out it's not one size small, it's about 10.
I thought I was ordering the size down from this.
This was the outcome. I'm not sure.
It looks silly.
It's just the ratio, you know, it's like a big lamp post. Is it a lamp post?
It looks silly, doesn't it?
And a small shade.
It looks silly.
Because when you turn the light on, you know how the light comes through. You want it to be bigger so that it sort of like lands down on the floor.
Just knows these kind of things. I measured it.
Did you measure it?
I measured that, thinking it was that.
You measured the diameter of the bottom,
thinking it was the diameter of the top. They should really specify.
I can't believe that.
Okay, well, you know what? I'm gonna stick with my guns here.
It's cute.
It's cute.
And you know what? It won't take up a lot of space if you're like walking past.
It looks weird, doesn't it?
It just looks a little funny.
You know what? I do have my pink lampshades from my old lamp.
As you know, I have these amazing Rachel Wyndham cushions, which were actually on my bed, but I thought they looked much better downstairs, especially, ignore my knife, on this little chair. I thought this one looked so cute. It's a bit plumpy in a funny shape right now, but you get the gist. I saw that Sophie Patton had done a collection with Andrew Martin, and I love my Rachel Wyndham cushions because they are so gorgeous and the fabric is so luxurious. These were on my bed, but I actually thought they looked better downstairs. And as you can see over here, this one looks better on this little chair as well. So anyway, I ordered some, and I'm not sure if I'm going to put them downstairs or on my bed.
All right, let's have a wee look.
The material of these are not like beds. That's more bed.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I told you Pia knows these things.
Look at that.
That looks great, I think.
I love it.
Same.
The problem is that when you actually sit on it, you're going to have some,
room on the sofa.
Show you a little close-up of these cushions. One of them has a little fraying on the outside. They're kind of both quite pastel and almost quite faded, which I really like. I didn't want anything too colourful. And one has more of a pattern on it, and then one is more almost like a matchstick, I guess, kind of vibe. And they look so great together. I'm really happy with them.
You are being awfully quiet upstairs today, aren't you? I wanted to give you a little tour of my handbags and how I'm storing them right now. And then maybe you can see how I'm storing them, and maybe it will give you some ideas. And really, this is this handbag storage and this shoe storage. Maybe I'll show you my shoes as well, but hold on. They're in there. This is something, by the way, I'm standing on a stool. This is something that I literally had in my dreams for years. I actually dreamt about seeing all my handbags and all my shoes out, because they've always just been kind of a bit crammed away. I mean, in my last place was probably the best I've ever seen them, but the storage wasn't enough for all my handbags and shoes, so it wasn't all of them.
And I know this is very shallow stuff. Trust me, I know. But I wanted to share it with you anyway because I have always been obsessed with bags and shoes, and being able to see them all like this really makes me happy. So when you open my cupboard, this is what you see. So I have at the top some bags up there that I don't really use or I'm not using right now, like this little guy, which I got when I was much younger, that bag, which I'm not using right now, and then there are drawers underneath. Let me go into this one because I know that's workout gear, and then there's like underwear and things. So let's go from the top shelf of bags. I have my three children, my Olympia Latam bags, which I adore and love so much. I love being able to see them like this, whereas in my last place I kind of stored them like that, which is a bit sad because they're so gorgeous. So I have these three here. This is kind of like the clutch section. I have my Cult Gaia clutch at the side, this amazing Alexander McQueen clutch, which I don't wear that much because it doesn't fit all that much inside. And then I have this one, which I unboxed in my last vlog, which is hands down my favorite bag ever right now. I mean, it's absolutely incredible. Then we go on to the next shelf. Sorry, this one doesn't sit up like I would like it to, but kind of ruins the vibe up in here. If you wouldn't mind sitting on your tushy. Okay, no, it's the rebel of the family. I have a few little bags. I have one clutch that doesn't fit up there, but mostly, I mean, that is facing the wrong way. That's gonna piss me off. This shelf is just a little bit less wide than this shelf, so I fit all the smaller bags in here. I have one of my all-time favorite Bulgari bags, my Marc Cross bag, Chloe, Prada, and then I have a few others at the back, like a vintage Chanel, my YSL bag. And then down here, I mean, this isn't a bag collection. I'll link my bag collections down below if you want to actually see them properly. But here is where I keep the big guns, basically the ones I use probably the most right now on this shelf. I have two Chanel bags. These two I wear all the time. This one is one of my Bulgari favorites. I've had it for a year now, but the Bulgari top handle bag. My favorite styles, my Dior, Lady Dior bag. This one I love. This mini Fendi peekaboo bag. I mean, I don't know what took me so long to get the shape in my life. And this Prada bag, which is the Cahir, and I wear that a lot as well. And then back there, you can see some other favorites like my Celine, my Gucci, yada, yada, yada. So there we go. That is the full shebang. I know you guys asked for a lot more house details in Vlogmas, so I hope I'm giving that to you right now. This is literally my pride and joy, this cupboard. Anytime someone's come over, I've literally been like, look at my shoes and my bags, because it just really excites me to be able to see everything in one place. This is where the magic really happens. This is my shoe cupboard. At the top here, don't know if you're gonna be able to see that, but I have flats and summer shoes, because obviously I ain't wearing these Hermes slides right now. And then I've kind of tried to lay them out one shoe per shelf, if you know what I mean, but where at the top when I don't see them all the time, I've kind of double whammied them. So we have my YSL Tribs back here. Back here is basically the high heel section, because these get pulled out on rarer occasions, I would say, than something like these. What do you think about this whole scenario? If anyone has recommendations for like shoe holders, if you know what I mean, to kind of hold these up and make them look nice, please can you let me know? Maybe like clear ones or something, because that really bothers me when it just falls like that. These are some of my all-time favorite shoes. I always buy my Rene Cavalier shoes from Luisa Via Roma, and I absolutely love them, although I wore them in the grass in France, so they have a little bit of dirt at the bottom of them, and which is not a vibe, but these kind of spring into place up here. So this is kind of the most crammed shelf, I would say. Oh, here we go, just cramming it in. Get in there, yeah, there we go. Then we get to the goods, basically. Here is kind of the anomaly shelf, I would say. I have a Manolo shelf and a Louboutin shelf, but these two didn't really fit on the shelf, so they're kind of here. These are amazing Manolos. They literally look like jewelry for your feet, and these are some of my all-time favorite Louboutins, even though they're so dirty a little bit. Then I have some Aquazuras here, and down below, let me just straighten this up for you so it looks super snazzy. This is, that wasn't me farting, that was a shoe. This is the Louboutin shelf I mentioned, and it's kind of like silver black. I mean, these shoes are literally something else. You've never seen anything like them in your life, I know. Oh. So that shelf just is one of my favorites. This style of pump is my favorite type of shoe, as you can see as we step down to the Manolo zone, basically. This shoe is hands down my favorite shoe of all time. It is literally the shoe that I put on and feel like an absolute princess. As you can see, I have a few different colors. This is the latest in my stash. Wow, now I take it out, you can really see the magic of the emerald satin. It is incredible, incredible, incredible. Then we go down a shelf and these are basically white shoes plus an Aquazura shoe, which I don't wear as much as I probably should, but I was going to wear these for something to do with my wedding. And I was gonna say I never got around to it, but you know what I mean? Most of my wedding relating things I either gave to friends who wanted them or donated, but these shoes I kept because I hadn't actually worn them at all yet. And I love crystal, beautiful, beautiful shoes. Oops. These I wear all the time, these I wear all the time. And then we come to the more flatter shoe area. Like, these are still shoes that I guess I could wear in winter if it wasn't that cold. These kind of shoes, I have my little Fendis. I still wear these Chanels a lot and these Miu Miu's as well. Then underneath we have a bit more random things. Like, I have these Manolos, these Malone Soulier, my trainers. And then under here I have boots. I had a pair of Zara boots, but I wore them this morning already to walk Duke. And I have some other boots in here. These boots, my Miu Miu boots. And that is my shoe cupboard done. Oh my gosh, look what just arrived. Oh my gosh, oh my gosh, oh my gosh. I need to open this in the most non-damaging way that I can to the reef. But I'm also so excited. Oh my gosh, it's so cute. There are little apples on it. You know it's winter Christmas time when you are roasting chestnuts. It smells so good. Outfit of the night, ready to go for dinner. I'm wearing a new Charlotte Tilbury lipstick, which is the color Glow Kiss. It's kind of like a pinky nude, very me. Kind of glossy, I really like it. Also wearing this Revolve off-shoulder little jumper. Got some leather pants on, gotta put on those boots in a second. And also gonna wear my little Fendi bag. The menu looks incredible. We're all literally shouting stuff out right now.
The only girl who is always picked to try the rosés, Dolly.
What do you think?
Just always says lovely. Thank you to Drunk Thursdays.
What's up, Big Ginger?
I'm great.
Pebble is so hot.
I feel a man knock on my shoulder and I was like, oh, hello! And he was like, your check is out, just letting you know.
Hold on.
I can't show you. It's there.
And now we're just going to see if I can just keep it on and see how many people tell me. Just commit to the tag. You know? Even the waitress keeps coming from behind.
You don't pay me.
Obviously Dolly was gonna finish that.
He had one girl. I had more than one girl.
Happy Vlogmas.
Woo!
Down it, down it, down it. I just said thank you to a random man in the waiter. That's when you know you're too drunk. Gotta go home.
Thank you.
Thank you.
She was our waiter.
Thank her.
Yeah. I was like, thank you, random man, eating his chicken stocking.
Oh my god, that's a heavy door. After a very fun evening, I'm getting into bed. It's been a day today. No, cheeky monkey. He always eats my sheets. You know what? You are not coming off as the best
little palm in this Vlogmas.
What is it about dogs, hey? What is it about them? They're just the best. The only little boo that I would share my bed with. But I need you on that side because this is my side, mate. Alright? Off you go. Oh, let's get rid of that. Oh, good boy. I mean, okay, you moved a tiny bit, but I need to move more. Here. Here, please. Go on. Off you go. Go on. Off you go over there. No, that's just a tiny bit. I need you to move over there properly. Go on. Here. Off you go. Good boy. Here. 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 Good boy, Duke. That's better.
Got there in the end, didn't we? Now I can go to sleep. I was going to journal tonight, and now I'm like, oh, drunk journaling. Is that really what I want to do? Probably not. Let me turn on that light there. I'm not used to these light switches. We had such good chats at dinner. Nothing like good old girl chats, hey? Anyway, I will end the day and the official first week of Vlogmas. I upload in Vlogmas Tuesday, Thursday and Sunday, so make sure you subscribe if you don't want to miss my videos. And I will see you on Instagram, and if not, I will see you on Tuesday with another vlog. Mwah. Night, guys.